on rotor parameters. We know that we can refer the induction motor to a transformer. The induction motor is also known as a rotating transformer. In transformer, we have two windings, namely primary and secondary. The primary winding of the transformer is referred to the stator of the induction motor, and the secondary winding of the transformer is referred to the rotor of the induction motor. In case of transformer, the frequency of the induced EMF in the secondary is same as the voltage applied to the primary. In the case of induction motor, at the starting condition, we know that speed is equal to 0 and slip is equal to 1. As long as slip is equal to 1, the frequency of the induced EMF in the rotor is same as the voltage applied to the stator. But as the motor gathers speed, the induction motor has some slip corresponding to the speed. In such case, the frequency of the induced EMF in the rotor is no longer same as that of stator voltage. Slip affects the frequency of the rotor induced EMF. Due to this, some other rotor parameters are also affected. The parameters which are affected by the slip are rotor frequency, magnitude of rotor induced EMF, rotor resistance and reactance, rotor power factor, and rotor current. Effect of slip on rotor frequency. In induction motor, the speed of rotating magnetic field is called as the synchronous speed. The synchronous speed is given by ns is equal to 120 f divided by p, where f is the frequency and p is the number of poles. At the starting condition, as we know, speed is equal to 0 and slip is equal to 1. As long as the slip is equal to 1, the frequency of the induced EMF is same as that of the supply frequency. But as the motor gains speed, there will be relative speed difference ns minus n, which is nothing but the slip speed. The slip speed is given by the formula ns minus n is equal to 120 fr by p, where fr is the frequency during the running condition. On dividing the equation 2 by 1, we get s is equal to fr divided by f, where s is the slip given by ns minus n divided by ns. Finally, fr is equal to s into f. Thus, we can conclude that the frequency of the rotor during the running condition is reduced slip times the supply frequency. Effect of slip on magnitude of rotor induced EMF. We know that the speed of the induction motor depends on the induced EMF on the rotor. During the standstill condition, slip is equal to 1 and speed is equal to 0. At this condition, the maximum EMF induced in the rotor depends on the maximum relative speed. The maximum relative speed obtained is the synchronous speed ns. Thus, the rotor induced EMF E2 is directly proportional to the synchronous speed ns. As the motor gathers speed, there will be the relative speed difference ns minus nr, where ns is the speed of the rotating magnetic field and nr is the rotor speed. The speed difference between ns minus nr depends on the induced EMF on the rotor during the running condition given as E2r. Therefore, the induced EMF during the running condition E2r is directly proportional to ns minus n. Using these two conditions, we can obtain that E2r divided by E2 is equal to slip s, where s is given by ns minus n divided by ns. Finally, E2r is equal to s into E2. We can conclude that the EMF induced in the rotor during the running condition is reduced by slip times the EMF induced during the standstill condition. Effect of slip on rotor resistance and reactance. We know that the induction motor can be classified into two types depending on the rotor construction. One is the squirrel cage induction motor and the other is slip ring induction motor. In slip ring induction motor, the rotor speed can be controlled by adding external resistance, whereas in spinning gauge induction motor, we don't have such provision. Now let us see how the slip affects the rotor resistance as well as reactance. We know that the rotor reactance X2 can be given as 2 pi F into L2. This is under the standstill condition. Now, if we consider the running condition, we know that FR is equal to S into F. We are going to replace FR in the place of F in X2 expression. Now, we obtain the expression for the reactance during the running condition. X2R is given by 2 pi FR into L2, where FR is nothing but S into F. On replacing, we finally obtain X2R is equal to S into X2. Thus, we can conclude that the rotor reactance during the running condition is reduced by slip times the rotor reactance during the standstill condition. Similarly, we can derive the expression for the rotor impedance during the running condition, which is given by Z2R is equal to square root of R2 square plus SX2 the whole square. Effect of slip on rotor power factor. We know that the power factor is given by R by Z. The rotor power factor during the standstill condition is similarly given by cos phi 2 is equal to R2 divided by Z2. On making replacement for Z2, we obtain the final expression for cos phi 2 as R2 divided by root of R2 square plus X2 square. Similarly, we are going to arrive the power factor during the running condition. It is given by cos phi 2 R is equal to R2 divided by Z2 R. On making replacement for Z2R, we obtain the final expression for cos phi 2R as R2 divided by root of R2 square plus SX2 the whole square. Effect of slip on rotor current. We know that the rotor current depends on the magnitude of the induced EMF and the impedance per phase. During the standstill condition, the rotor current is given by I2 is equal to E2 divided by Z2. Now, we are going to replace the rotor current with the running condition. So, the rotor current during the running condition is given by I2R. Thus, I2R is equal to E2R divided by Z2R. On making suitable replacements for the running condition parameters E2R and Z2R, we arrive at the final expression for I2R, which is given by I2R is equal to SE2 divided by root of R2 square plus SX2 the whole square. These are the rotor parameters on which the effect of slip is influenced. Thank you.